Good morning students, welcome to Computer Aided Design course, course code P20DE102. I am Virakesh, assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Kids Warangal. In this video lecture, I am going to deliver one lecture on mathematical representation of surfaces in Computer Aided Design course. Before going to enter this topic, let us see the lecture outcome for this topic. After completion of this lecture, student will be able to determine the mathematical representation of equation for surfaces. Coming to this topic, in the previous video lecture, we discussed about mathematical representation of curves. The curves are classified into two different forms. One is non-parametric curves and second one is parametric curves. Here also, similarly, these surfaces are classified into two types, non-parametric surfaces and parametric surfaces. In computer graphics and CAD/CAM requires developing the proper equations and algorithms for both computation and programming purposes. Moreover, surface description is usually related to machining requirements to manufacture the surface. The surface description must successfully drive a tool to generate its path. Surface can be described mathematically in three-dimensional space by non-parametric form or parametric equation form. There are several methods to fit non-parametric surfaces to a given set of data points. These fall into two categories. In the first category, one equation is fitted to pass through all the points, while in the second, the data points are used to develop a series of surface patches that are connected together with at least position and first derivative continuity. Let us see the point P on a non-parametric surface patch. You can see this figure. Here I have taken one point on a non-parametric surface patch in the Cartesian coordinates x, y, z. Now, the equation of the surface or surface patch for non-parametric equations given by P equal to x, y, z transpose x, y, f of x comma y transpose. Here z equal to f of x comma y, similar like mathematical representation of non-parametric curves. The natural form of the function f of x comma y for a surface to pass through all the given data points is a polynomial, that is z equal to f of x comma y. Now we can also write f of x comma y polynomial is summation m equal to 0 to p, summation n equal to 0 to q. This is in x direction, this is the in y direction. A m n x power m y power n. This is the equation number 2. Here, where the surface is described by an xy grid, the grid size is p plus 1 into q plus 1 control points. Coming to parametric representation of surface, the parametric representation of a surface means it is a continuous vector valued function, that means p of u comma v of two variables. Here u is one variable in x direction, v is the another variable in y direction, are parameters u and v, where the variables are allowed to range over some connected region of the UV plane. So as they do so, p of u comma v assumes every position on a surface. The function p of u comma v at certain u and v values is the point on the surface at these values. You can see here in the parametric space, the minimum value is u minimum, u max. In the y direction, v minimum and v max. The most general way to describe the parametric equation of a three-dimensional curved surface in the space is P equal to x, y, z transpose equal to, here we can represent in each and every point, each and every Cartesian in the parametric form, x of u comma v, y of u comma v, z of u comma v transpose. This is similar like mathematical representation of parametric curves. Here the limits are u minimum less than or equal to u less than or equal to u max. Here u lies in between u minimum and u max. In y direction, v lies in between u v minimum and v max. this equation gives coordinates of a point on the surface and the components of its position vector. You can see this is the point P of u comma with the position vector. It uniquely map the parametric space e square means in the u and v values to the Cartesian space means x comma y comma z, that means u cube in x comma y comma z values. The parametric variable u and v are constrained intervals bounded by minimum value and maximum value. In most surfaces these intervals lies in between 0 and 1. The minimum value is 0 and maximum value is 1 for both u and v values. This equation 3 suggests that a general three-dimensional surface can be modeled by dividing it into an assembly of topological surfaces. You can see here, a patch is considered the basic mathematical element to model a composite surface. You can see this figure. This figure shows a two patch surface where u and v values lies in between 0 and 1. U equal 0, u equal 1. V equal 0 and v equal 1. The topology of a patch may be rectangular or triangular. Some surface may consist of one patch only, while other may be a few patches connected together. The topology of a patch may be rectangular or triangular. You can see it. This is the triangular patch and this is a rectangular patch and this is a triangular patch. Triangular patches add more flexibility. The advantage of triangular patches, it adds more flexibility in surface modeling because they do not require ordered rectangular arrays of data points to create a surface at the rectangular patches. Both triangular and rectangular cones and Bezier patches are available in CAD-CAM systems. This surface may classify into two types. One is analytical surface, another one is synthetic surfaces. Analytical surfaces are based on wireframe entities and include plane surface, ruled surface, surface of revolution and tabulated cylinder. The another one is synthetic surfaces are formed from a given set of data points or curves and include bicubic, Bezier, B-spline and cones patches. There are few methods to generate synthetic surfaces such as tensor product method, rational method and blending method. The rational method develops rational surfaces, which is an extension of rational curves. The other one is the blending method. The blending method approximates a surface by piecewise surfaces. Let us take one patch, a rectangular patch. here there is a set of boundary conditions associated with the rectangular patch. You can see here this patch is developed by four boundary curves. This is the boundary curve 1, and this is the curve 2, and this is the curve 3, and this is the curve 4. There are 16 vectors and 4 boundary curves. The vectors are 4 position vectors for the 4 corners. You can see here, this is the position vector corner P of 0, 0. This is the corner 2, P of 1, 0. This is the corner 3, P of 1, 1. This is the corner 4, P of 0, 1. And 8 tangent vectors, each corner having 2 tangent vectors in u direction and v direction. At point P of 0, 0, the tangent vector is dou P by dou V P 0, 0. In y direction, the tangent vector is dou P by dou U P 0, 0. At point P of 1, 0, tangent vector in x direction, that is dou P by dou V P 1, 0. In y direction, dou P by dou U P 1, 0. At point 3, that is P of 1, 1, tangent vector in x direction, dou P by dou U P 1, 1. In y direction, dou P by dou V P 1, 1. At corner 4, that is P of 0, 1, tangent vector in x direction, dou P by dou U P 0, 1. In y direction, dou P by dou V P 0, 0, 1. And 4 twist vectors, each and every corner point having 1 twist vector. At point P 0, 0, dou square P by dou U dou V. At corner point P of 1, 1, twist vector is dou square P by dou U dou V P 1, 0. At corner point P 1, 1, twist vector dou P by dou U dou V P 1, 1. Position vector P of 0, 1, twist vector is dou square P by dou U dou V P 0, 1. The 4 boundary curves are described by holding one parametric variable fixed at one of its limiting values and allowing the other to change freely. The boundary curves are then defined by the curve equations U equals 0, U equal to 1, V equal 0, and V equal to 1 in y direction. Now apply the tangent vector concept to this rectangular patch. The tangent vector at any point P of u comma v on the surface, P u of u comma v. In this case, v is constant. In this case, v is constant. Dou P by dou U equal to dou x by dou u I cap plus dou y by dou u j cap plus dou z by dou u k cap. Limits are in x direction u minimum less than or equal to u less than or equal to u max. In y direction v minimum less than or equal to v less than or equal to v max. Similarly, tangent vector in y direction pv u comma v equal to dou P by dou V equal to dou x by dou V I cap plus dou y by dou V j cap plus dou z by dou V k cap. Limits are u minimum less than or equal to u less than or equal to u max. In y direction, v minimum less than or equal to v less than or equal to v max. This is the equation number 5. Now combine these two equations and write in matrix form. PU PV equal to dou x by dou u, dou y by dou u, dou z by dou u. Second row, dou x by dou v, dou y by dou v, dou z by dou v. You can see here these components of each unit vector. These components of each unit vector are already shown in the previous figure. if the dot product of this two tangent vector, that means PU dot PV, it gives zero at a point on a surface, that means these two vectors are perpendicular to one another. You can see it. Let us take this one, PU dot PV equals zero. It gives these two curves, these two tangent vectors are perpendicular to each other. So similarly, at every point, the two tangent vectors are perpendicular, so it forms one rectangular patch. You can say this figure shows the tangent vectors at the corner points of a rectangular patch, and a point Pij, you can say this is a Pij, the notation dou P by dou U Pij, for example, it means that the derivative calculated at the point Pij defined by U equal to Ui in x direction, V equal to Vj in y direction. Tangent vectors are useful in determining boundary conditions for patching surfaces together, as well as defining the motion of the cutters along the surfaces during manufacturing process. Now let us write the magnitude and unit vector of tangent vectors are given by PU equal to determinant of PU. Magnitude of position vector in x direction under root dou x by dou u whole square plus dou y by dou u whole square plus dou z by dou u whole square. Similarly in y direction, a position determinant of PV equal to under root dou x by dou v whole square plus dou y by dou v whole square plus dou z by dou v whole square. This is the equation number 7. Now write the unit vector. Nu cap equal to PU by determinant of PU. Similar in y direction, NV cap equal to PV by determinant of PV. This is the equation number 8. Next, the twist vector is the twist vector at a point on a surface is said to measure the twist in the surface at the point. It is the rate of change of the tangent vector PU with respect to V, or PV with respect to U, or it is cross or mixed derivative vector at the point. Now let us take now you can see this figure. This is a geometric interpretation of twist vectors. This figure shows the geometric interpretation of the twist vector. If we increment u and v by delta u and delta v, delta u and delta v respectively, and draw the tangent vectors, incremental changes PU and PV at point P, whose position vectors is P of u comma v, are obtained by translating PU of u comma v plus delta v in x direction, PV of u plus delta u comma v in y direction to P, forming the two translating vectors. The incremental rate of change of the tangent vectors become delta PU by delta V and delta PV by delta U, and the infinitesimal rate of change is given by the following limits, that is limit delta V equals 0, delta PU by delta V equal to dou PU by dou V equal to dou square P by dou U dou V equal to PUV. Similarly in y direction, limit delta U to 0, delta PV by delta U equal to dou PV by dou U equal to dou square PV by dou U dou V, that equal to PUV. Now you can write in the Cartesian form. PUV equal to dou square x by dou u dou v, dou square y by dou u dou v, dou square z by dou u dou v transpose. That equal to dou square x by dou u dou v I cap plus dou square y by dou u dou v j cap plus dou square z by dou u dou v k cap. The limits are u minimum less than or equal to u less than or equal to u max, v minimum less than or equal to v less than or equal to v max. The twist vector depends on both surface geometric characteristics and its parameterization. Due to the latter dependency, interpreting the twist vector in geometric terms may be misleading, since PUV not equal to zero does not necessarily imply a twist in a surface. For example, a flat plane is not a twisted surface. However, depending on its parametric equation, PUV may or may not be zero. The surface normal at a point is a vector, that is nu, u comma v equal to dou p by dou u into dou p by dou v, that equal to pu cross pv. The normal vector is n cap equal to n by determinant n. This equal to pu cross pv by determinant of pu cross pv. This is the brief discussion about how to determine the mathematical representation of a surfaces. Lecture outcome revisited. Having completed the discussion on mathematical representation of surfaces, now students should be able to determine the mathematical representation of equation for surfaces. Further reading, the students are requested to follow the given textbook, that is Ibrahim Jeed and Shiva Subramaniam R.R. CAD/CAM Theory and Practice, second edition, New Delhi, Tata McGraw-Hill, 2010. The reading chapter number is 5.4 and the page number is 252. Thank you for watching. Please do like and subscribe my channel for more updates.